and welcome to Mod Source 2. Well, at least it's starting from Mod Source 2. First plan of attack, of course, is to get out of this lovely day. And we'll head off with this reasonably good spawn so far. We'll just get out of here so we're not being attacked by anything. And I'll do my normal trick of just going underground and finding something. Really should find something to make some wood out of. This is Mod Source with everything enabled. And we will be playing this for a little while. Ah, a tree. Always a good start. A tree. Getting some achievements. For those watching the how-to series, this part of the process is always just the same as vanilla Minecraft. We find some trees, and we start off making ourselves some tables and some protection. And now I'm going to burrow myself into a hill and start doing some resource gathering. And I'll come back, and we can have a bit of a look around. Okay, so I found myself in this little hole right here. I'll block it off, and start working on the making it a bit bigger so I can actually use it. Quite a number of mods in this pack. We are possibly going to have some interesting things, and I'm having a water problem again. A lot of water in this pack so far. I've dug into four different walls, and so I found water in all of them. But I did find myself a sheep, and I can hear a sheep on top of me. So I have a nice collection of stuff here. Let's make ourselves a furnace. I haven't gone looking for any coal yet, but we'll just cook up some wood. Just so I got some food. Charcoal. It's reasonably easy to get the wood, so we'll do that now. As you see, it's 199 pages of mods. Some I've got experience with, some I don't. I need to cook some food. Got a collection of different lambs and the rest of the things provided by Still Hungry. Hoping that they're actually reasonably good to eat. As we get further on, of course, I'll start playing with some of the more important mods, like the ones that keep your water fed, which is always a helpful thing to have. So, I'll put that in there as well, and do a bit more looking around. I might go kill the sheep that's out here. Probably should make myself a sword. Watch out for that. Hole in the ground there, because that would be a good place to fall. Increase my death count. That gives me 2. I need one more. Make myself a bed so that we can sleep away the night. Poor sheep, I'm so sorry. There we go. So I'll head back over here. I might take down this tree while I'm here. Yes, I'm attacking the wood with a piece of dirt. because that's just how you do it. Axes are so last year. And we'll just fall off the piece of dirt. Not a great fan of the hanging trees, so we'll just finish that off as well. And then we'll head back into the little house that I have made. And cook up some of the that. And let's make ourselves a bed to sleep in. I'm playing on a server, which means I won't be able to always sleep, but at least we'll have a bit, we'll have some protection. And of course I also need, I do not have, wasn't the most clever of things to do. Used all my charcoal. Need a piece of charcoal to make a torch. And we have a piece of charcoal. We don't need to cook up the chicken apparently. Cook that up. One of those, and one of those. Okay, this is a torch. That is an interesting thing. Place it on the wall here. And, continue making it a bit bigger. This part of the game is always quite boring. It's very vanilla. That's the beginning of the game, so we have to expect a little bit. And it looks like I'm about to lose my pickaxe. I really should make myself a stone one. I might do that now while I'm thinking about it. Let's grab some more sticks. One, two, three. Stick. And while I'm here, let's make a shovel. And of course, I don't have enough for a. Yes, I do. Sorry, what am I on? Do I have enough for a sword? It's not a great sword, but it's a sword nonetheless. Still a bit of day out there, so we could go have a look. I'll just finish up in here. Oh, what good timing that was. Okay. So, home sweet home. Probably should make a door for there. Let's make a door. I don't know if how strong the zombies are in this game, but nothing else. I've got a door to do something. Probably should actually have a door, not a wooden door. Throw it down here. One door. Oh, we got 3 doors out of that. That's unusual. And we're being asked to sleep, so I'm doing that. And there we are. Now I'm just going to go do a bit more exploring outside. What's out here? If it's still daytime, I haven't cycled through the IAM. So, let's go have a look and see what's down here. Thought I heard a skeleton then. I did hear a skeleton. Oh, ducks. Okay, how interesting. Probably should find myself something to actually do besides running around. Oh, what a good spawn location. Mark this one out for when I've got myself a diamond pick. So I think someone else doesn't take it, I think. It's a nice spot for it. Let's mark it right here. Somewhere. Stone. And we'll just go up here. In fact, I probably should go find myself some diamonds. Yeah, pig. How helpful. And I'd like to know why I'm not using my sword. I probably should hit that with my hand. Come back here, Mr. Pig.
Mr. Pig, Mr. Pig.
Excellent. And where's the other one? Oh, there's a whole bunch of pigs here. Oh, and another one. What a find! I'm not entirely sure what's running around. I think there's a bird catching itself on fire. Not the most intelligent of the creatures apparently in this game. Quite away from spawn. I'll continue on this way. Go over the hill and far away. Might have to dig into the hole and make my builder base downwards. Go into here. And go home again. So, this pack. What have we got here? We've got all sorts of different things. AE2 stuff. Apple Morgan Tea. AE2. Aquatic Abyss. Aroma's Dimensional World, which would be nice to set up as a mining world. Artifacts, Aurora Cascade, Automagy. It looks like something different. It looks like something to do with Formcraft. Auto Packager, Balls, Better Furnaces, RF compatibility. Not entirely sure what that provides. Bibliocraft, Big Reactors, Biome Wand, Biome Plenty. Blood Magic, Blue Power, Batania, Carpenter's Block, Chicken Chunks, Chisel 2, Compact Machines, oh I like that mod. Compact Storage, Computer Craft, another one I like, so I'll probably be looking for diamonds pretty quick. Deco Craft, Alimetrics, Endo, Ender Storage, Ender Tech, Hunt's Portals, Erebus, X Asterisk. X Nihalo, Exotic Birds, which we've seen a lot of those flying around. Extended Villages, that sounds like an interesting mod. Extra Cells, Extra Utilities, Extra Buttons, Extra Thermans, Tinker's Construct, Floodlights, Forbidden Magic, Forge Microblocks, Funky Locomotion, Ganny's Nether, Ganny's Surface, Hardcore Ender Expansion, Iguana Tinker Twinks. Aha! That explains some questions that came up earlier. Immersive Engineering, which I really would like to play with. Iron Backpacks, Iron Chest, Jurassic Craft, so like dinosaurs. Magmanus Tools, Mantle Mechanism, another great mod there. Mechanism Generators. Oh, a bit too far. Where are we? Minecraft. Oh, that's a funny mod to have any. Mine Factory Reloaded, Necromancy, Nether Wars, Noddle Mechanics. Oh, that is. Some form of. Oh, okay, it's related to Thorncraft. Open Blocks, Origin, Passive Torch. Okay. Pistronics. Okay, that's interesting. Practicalities, which is a great mod, it was in the previous mod pack. Mod Source mod pack. Quinlilib. I assume it's an extension or something. Quantum Flux, Quiverblow. Redstone Arsenal, RF Tools, Simple Labels, Simply Jetpacks. Solar Flux, Soul Shards Reborn, Space Core. Steve's Factory Manager, we'll get into a bit of that later on. Still Hungry, which seems to add a lot of different foods. Storage Drawers, Tall Doors mod, Thorncraft, obviously, we've got all that extra add ons. Energetics, Expansion, Tinker, Torment Tinkerer, Thermodynamics, Thermal Expansion. Where are we? Thermal Foundation, Tinker's Construct, Tinker's Mechworks Tube Transport System, which apparently is an interesting mod to play with. Warp Book, and some Redstone stuff, and Zetones. So we've got a nice little collection of mods here, and we might actually have a bit of fun. It's currently still night time, I assume. Yep, we can probably sleep and get passes away. So we'll do a bit of sleeping. Why do I hear a ghast? That's not a good sound. Just trying to get someone else to sleep. There we go. I'm not sure I want to go out there and find out if it's a ghast or not. Let me just grab something to eat. I'll use some chicken. What is it called? I should make this chest on here, shouldn't I? Do we have any wood left? We have a little bit of wood. Probably enough for a chest. Don't know if I want that chest. Let's put one of these down. We'll just place it at the end of the bed here. Dump all that in there. Grab that just in case. What else we got here? Grab that just as much, and I'll leave that in there just in case I need it later. And we'll grab some building blocks. I really need these books. I don't think that you've read the books. There's probably something useful in them, but I don't know. So we'll just go into here, and we'll have a look around here and see what we can do. It's a little worrying that I could hear a ghast in the overworld. Hoping it's just a mod where someone's being a bit lazy on the sounds. Bit of a drop there. Oh, bit of a drop. That one fall down there. Alright, let's have a look. There's nothing down here. So I'm assuming it's running under my base, which would be really not quite nice to have. Ghast living with me. Of course, ghasts are never friendly, which also wouldn't be good. I won't stand in the quicksand, thank you. Quicksand can't be good for anybody. So, let's just have a look around here. So we've got a lot of botania around, a few flowers. Obviously got the extra utilities. I think I saw extra utilities in there. We've got computer craft, and we can actually start doing some work, so I think for now, we don't really need a lot from the surface. Besides having a look around to see what's here. So I might start doing some mining. And really get us underway in terms of what we have. I don't know why I picked a hill. It wasn't very clear. We'll just head back up here and start mining underground. Oops, I'm going this way over here. Down we go. Where are we here? Probably should make something to actually go down there and protect us, but we'll just go down here, make a nice little hole. Let's see, I don't know. Perhaps should make it out here, maybe? No, I've done that in the past, and it wasn't very successful when something came out in the middle of the night. Let's go down this way. I might also make myself a new pick. Bit of copper. Copper is very useful. Well, at least it will be. It's not currently very useful. So let's go step down here. Hopefully, we will be able to do some mining and get some ores pretty quickly. What I'm going to do is I'm going to cut the video here and do some mining if I find anything interesting or include including diamonds or anything else. Let's not do that. Raw wire. I'll cut you in. Otherwise, I'll see you when I've finished doing some more resource gathering. Ruby ore. It's funny how early game you find all this coal and you go, oh, cool, coal. And then as the game gets further on, you end up just ignoring it. Tesselerite oil? Ore? Not. Where's that noise again? What's it hearing noises of nether portals? It's like there's a some form of access to the nether around here. I really shouldn't be looking into this, but you know. Oop, that was clever. Take out my torch. Let's have a look and see what's on here. There's Jurassic Craft. This is the cave I found before. Well, I'm not entirely sure where the noise of the gas is coming from. It's got me a bit too curious. Chance that that will get me a kill. There's some copper ore from Blue Power. I'll still have a torch on there and hopefully it will protect me from whatever's down there. It's a lot of copper ore. Uh oh. Just block that off for now. Hopefully nothing comes out and jumps at me. It's a very nice cave. Except for the noises of zombies and ghasts. Okay, I found something. One zombie down there. Take him out. Take him out. Reluctant to die. Oh! There goes my pick. Interest in what's down here. Dropped something useful. I just fell down there, it wasn't really there. Let's get out of here quickly. Might come back to you, so we'll go. Okay. And we'll pop there. Oh! Oh! Oh, that's good. That's good. Don't normally have that in this game. Normally it takes quite a number of episodes to get this level. And oh, these are more than that. Oh nice. That could be an issue. Does look like we're protected under there. And we're protected there. So yeah, no, we should be good. Yeah, but so I'll grab a couple of those, nothing else. Oh, got a full inventory. Let's get rid of the stone. Don't know quite how I got stone. Woot. And we'll grab, and just make sure we're safe under here as well. Yes, we are. Cool, grab those. And what about under here? Awesome. Okay. Cool. That's enough for me. I think I'll head back. Base and work on my first little toy, because the one thing that you do when you get diamonds, or at least I do, is use them. Time to make myself a pick. Oops. Oh dear, I've been mining a bit too much around here. Up we go. Just about there. Oop. Not sure I want to know what that noise is. That's not a good noise. But I'm going to just ignore it for now. Oh dear. Well, I'll sleep. Probably should unload my inventory. Just wait. Can't even convince people to sleep at night. There we go. Awesome. Okay, so I'll just unload my inventory before I go anywhere else. Let's just drop off some of that stuff. Just so I've got enough room to pick up. Wood like this, and I'll take a little torch because, well, why not? Take that out, it's two pieces, it's enough for what I need. Go back into our house, let's convert it into planks. Two planks make this stick. Oh dear. Oh dear. We'll just put that down there for now. 1, 2, 3. Actually, let's say we're looking for a turtle. That's the first thing I always work on, is a turtle. We need some iron ingots. I do have some iron around here somewhere. Question is, do I have enough iron? Right, so, well, there we go, some iron. Just stick some of that in there. We have some of that. We'll cook up our iron. Take the copper out. Stick that in there. It's about one. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We need some stone as well. I picked up some redstone, so we're pretty good to go. Might need to grab some sand, because I don't think I've picked any sand up yet. We're right next to a beach. Oh, there we go, look at that. We are ready to go with the sand as well. Excellent. Let's wait for this to finish. 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 6. Just got enough for a total. Seven, and we'll cut up. Cook up some of that. I think it's 8, isn't it? I think it might actually be 7. Yeah, 7, that'll do. Put those up there, put it in there. Need some more oak wood. There's planks on the ass. I'm gonna drop some more stuff off. Let's just drop some more off. Boom, boom. Go out here, and once again, just take out. The tree is one right next to our base. The door. Let's make kind of all that there. We'll make ourselves another chest, which is what we need for the turtle. Offload some of this again. Put it in there. Oh, we ran out. How annoying. 2 stone. While I'm here, one thing I've been looking at, thinking about doing, and I haven't done yet, is convert this to a Tinker's Crafting Station. For anybody who doesn't know, a Tinker's Crafting Station allows you to keep your inventory, so we could set up our inventory already, so we can go in here, we can say we need a piece of redstone in the middle. Pondering of stopping that, but we'll leave it right. No room left. But an inventory management problem at the moment. That should change in a moment though. Cook up the glass. So we're looking at stone all around. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wait for a piece of glass, there it is. And I've just realised that to make a pane of glass, you actually need more than that. We actually need 6. Is there a way of making it any other way? No, okay, we do need 6. I have 5. Okay, well, we can cook that up if nothing else. And I'm just going to put this in here because that's a really. Actually, no, not that. That and that. And I'll just go grab some. Thing. Should have our. Peach out here. Which hopefully has a little bit of sand in it. Last time I checked, they have sand all over the place. Just stand on these mini cactuses. Not quite sure why there's a. Not a great fan of taking sand in the middle of nowhere. Run over here and take out. Let's take it up the side here, should be enough. Go back to the base. Boy, you can do all those things again. Definitely need to make a way of getting up here a bit quicker. What the hell? Through we go. And of course, 5, 6. I'll just cook up 3 of them. That's our 5. Need 1 more to make a piece of glass. sixth. Of course, can't do that. I have to put these in first. 16 of those. Under here, click on the computer. Shift click on the question mark. One computer. Shift click on that. We have a turtle. Combine the turtle with the diamond pickaxe. We have a mining turtle. And now, I'm just going to put the turtle down here, and I'm going to write up, cut here, and I'm just going to write up my program to do a bit of digging for me. Just a very basic program I normally write up on these things. And I'll come back once it's done. Okay, so I've written up my diggy program. It's pretty much just copying what I've done in my previous games. Pretty basic program, doesn't really do a lot. Moves the toilet forward and back. Place down some torches, and gives you basic mining ability. You do need to follow behind it, but hey, if I don't have to dig it, it's much better. So, we'll just give this computer a name, we'll call him Digit. And then we can break him, and he won't lose his programming. Head back downstairs. In fact, I might just make up some torches. Enough. 14. Oh, a bit too many, but that's fine. 64 will be perfect. So we head down, back down to diamond level. All the way down here. Might just stop to eat something if I've got something to eat. Apparently I don't have something to eat. That might be a good thing to go grab first. Going up the hill, hoping I don't die before I get there. And I open up my chest. Cook up some more chicken, I suppose. Ah, got some cooked mutton. That's probably good enough. We'll just cook up some extra just in case. And I'll head down. The cool thing about having the turtle is I can set him off to this thing and come back and have a check on him later. So we head down here. Not my best at cave systems, but gets me there. Definitely a good day when you find diamonds in the first episode. So it's just around here when I found them, I think it was. Right, the cave, no, it wasn't here. Where are those diamonds? Oh, that must be around here. Place it. Oh, silver, really? Is a good place to, I think. So what we do with this guy is we just put him down, open him up, we stick torches in the first lot, we run diggy, and we don't run diggy, we actually have to give him fuel first, so let's give him a bit of fuel, we'll do torch. Yeah, so let's just refuel. Refuel, let's give him a 10 should be enough to give him the air in the corners. Now we put our torches back in the slot, run diggy. And he will dig in with a pattern. We just run behind him. Take out anything that looks worth having. This is the redstone, bit of ruby, bit more redstone, yellows man, still need coal, and because he's a turtle, I'm not rocking here. That should just be on us. He's not going to have a problem with the barber. On my course, though, silly enough to walk into it. Now let's see if I can find a place of blocking it. There we go. Hopefully we're safe here. Yep. Not sure about there. No, I've got a problem there, so we'll just jump out of there. Block off. So you can currently hear him going through the lava. Be nice and safe. We go along here, we take out anything else that looks interesting. Such as the needle. Redstone. But as you can see, place to talk to it as we go, so it makes it a lot easier to mine. He does most of the work for you. At least the grunt work. Should be reasonably well lit as well. Grunts with decay is a problem, but doesn't normally help happen. Oop, shouldn't be using the iron on that, it's a bit of a waste. I can hear that lava, so I'm not going to go too far into the wall without very close. I think I'll leave most of that for now. Got a bit of copper all there. Oh, and there's your problem. There's your lava. So we just need to block that off a little bit. Probably the first time he's really run into a lava source like that. The key is just to block it off so that it doesn't get in the way, and we'll probably go back this way. Might even take out this iron that's sitting here. So it's still very boring mining, but it's a lot better. Find a lot faster to follow behind him and just take out the stuff you want. And of course, he collects the stuff as well. Oh, what's that in there? Cinnabar. Not really interested in cinnabar. Need to bridge across there. And there. One of the other things he doesn't do is he doesn't actually. Break it, there he is there. So you can see he's running along the side there. Just drop into here. Let's see if there's anything we want in here, like the needle. We have to use an iron, oops, iron pick for. The silver. I'm not entirely sure what that. No, the cave, okay. It's the cave we came across before. So yeah, I've got a bit of. All the way along here. Got some infused stone. I'm not a great fan of Formcraft. Might get into it this season, but possibly, possibly not. Not sure. Maybe there for now. Don't really want to waste my inventory on dumb stuff. See what's left in here, not really anything. Quantum flux, that sounds like an interesting one. Just pop that off so it doesn't get in the way. Let's head over here. Ooh, that's a heavy one. Might have to. Titanium ore needs diamond. So I'm gonna come back here so I can find it later. Just turn that waypoint off, however, so I don't constantly see it all the time. Head around here. Right into the next little lava. Please. We're going to come to towards me. Looks like I'm safe. Oops. Still don't know what to say. Interesting. Except for a cave or something in there. Don't think shifting helps here. There we go. Step back so I don't get covered in the lava. Adjust. And there too. There's probably nothing in here. But we'll have a go anyway. Alright, we're flying down there. Closer than I thought would. This piece gonna go, it is, look at that. Okay, oh look at that, we've got some gold straight ahead. Glad I came down here now. I haven't found any gold yet. Probably behind there. Whoops. Just about gone, is it gonna go? Okay, so. Oh, and he's actually stopped here as well. Oh, he's full. Okay, so am I. That's not good. What can I get rid of? Let's take some of that out. Take the redstone. Oh no, I don't have enough for that. Okay. Probably throw that. Don't need the gravel. Don't need the cobblestone. Don't really need flint at the moment. Where is this? I'll just stick. Okay. Don't mind as I need that either. I don't think I picked any of that up now. I'll pick some of that up. Pick some dirt up. Coal. Cobblestone. I don't need cobblestone. Okay, I actually picked it up. That's awesome. And then we just move all this over here. And he will detect that he's empty again and start moving forward. Hopefully. Any moment now. Any moment now. There we go. Yeah, we just keep going until we get full again. Some more gold up there. Some ferrous. Oop! Just about got myself killed there. Knowing it. I'm gonna have to throw something out. What are we gonna throw? Gold that I don't really need. Stuff that I've thrown on the ground before, so let's pop it back in my inventory. There we go, is that the gold? That is the gold, awesome. So what I think I might do here is I'll head to the top of the thing here, leave my turtle to do some more digging for me, and call it to end the video. Hopefully you learnt something in this game. It might be a bit boring, probably the first episode. First episodes normally are quite a boring video because there's a lot of mining, a lot of resource gathering. But if you did enjoy it, or you want to see more of the series, please do leave a like. If you want to see, if you want to be notified when there's a new video, subscribe to the channel. Got any questions, or you want to get hold of my Diggy program, please leave a comment, and we'll see what we can do. Let's start over there, stick all that in there. But on that note, I will say goodbye. Thanks for watching. See ya. Oh, bingo! Easy.